very big company making, farming equipment, things like that, tractors, you know. They are suppliers today. Earlier, what they used to do, they will send some parts. It will come to the factory. Then they will say, no, this is under dimension, this is over dimension, this is correct. So sorting out takes place, rejection takes place in the factory. So how much time is wasted? You produce it and bring it here and all. Today, because of this, a modified version of the Google Glass, that you see the worker puts it on and then does, automatically it gives the reading, dimension. So when he is making the component, it gives you, it is pretty close, so I have to now, my material removal must be closer. So he does carefully. So if you give such gadgets, such technology, it will be extremely useful. But on the other hand, if everything is done by the company and this fellow is said, go and sit at home, that is there. But on the other hand, it's already happening. In India, previous economic advisor to the government, that professor from the US, who has gone back, what is his name?
Raghuram Rajan.
Not Rajan, the other fellow. The Shivaram Krishna or something.
Yes.
Subramanian.
Yes, Subramanian.
So, Arvind Subramanian, in fact, wanted that to be included in our last year's budget itself, which is called basic salary. So that means in Western countries today, they are planning for a situation where robots will replace you. You will sit at home, but then you have to live. So therefore, every citizen will be given some basic pay. You know, you can sit at home, and of course, you know, what will you do with the free time? So that means you have to be educated how to employ your free time other than throwing stones. Is there any other creative activity in which they can engage? So that means this is also happening. In America, California today, there is one company where there is not one single human being. Everything is produced by robots. Already it is happening. So in India also it may happen, you know, all these fellows, laborers will strike, they will fall ill, they may take leave because of the family reasons, something is there. Robo never does all that. So therefore let us have robots. This is how it started. So that is why I give, at least my counseling in TGS is this, that this industrial robotization has occurred because of two reasons. One is, the salary is so high that people want to replace human being. That is what happened in the US. Or, countries like Germany, where there is a shortage. You know, for example, in one of my visits in 2004 or something, when I reached there, one fellow came to me and said, I would like to go back to India, can you help me get a job? At that time, I said, he said there are only 25,000 vacancies. I may find it difficult to get. And the 2 month period over, I asked him, are you still interested? There is some possibility. He said, no. Then why? It has already increased to 85,000. So therefore, there is a shortage of manpower. Therefore, Germans went for automation. We are in a very funny state. We want to develop. Point is, you also know the kind of, Tamil Nadu is a classic case. 593 colleges. Out of which 100 colleges, not even one fellow passes. So the professor in charge of those colleges, some time ago, he came to my room and said, sir, in this college, in this 100 colleges, not even one fellow has passed. Why should I recommend that they should be continued? I have no power to discontinue. So this is the situation. So we are producing people who are not employable. So that is the other thing. So therefore, because of that, automation is taking place. For example, one of the things, TCS has come up with is, you see, today what you do, you go to your bank, you want to open an account. This Chandan Yojana Modi, it has created a lot of accounts. So that means number of accounts you create is so much that the work for the banks have increased. So what happens is, now you fill the writing, then you give it to that fellow puts it on something, he scans it, then that scanned one, he sends by email to someone else, and then that fellow opens. Now, we have come up with a pen, at the end of it there is a camera. So as you are writing, it gets automatically photographed and directly it goes to that fellow and it is there. So that means with five, you know, in the same time you can register five fellows, open five accounts. This has been immediately implemented by Citibank. State Bank of India, which is having greater problem because of this, Jan Yojana, everything goes to State Bank of India because it's government. They are not able to introduce because the union says you are going to replace them four fellows. So this is where our difficulty comes. So neither we are able to do it, nor we are able to accept the technology. I mean, how to improve the human skill so that at least it can give a decent competition to the machine. If it does not happen, you know, it is bound to happen. So many people are going to be thrown out of the job. Now, you know, it will be unavoidable. You know, this is what happened. When the first time computerization started, all the unions were against it. But today, all are using computers. Right? I mean, you know, if you want to transfer some money to you or I want to transfer some money to you, I can do it in 5 minutes now. I just go there and punch a few buttons and it is in your account. It has been made possible because of technology. So, if some benefit is there, people will say, I don't care whether half a dozen fellows are thrown on the job. So that means this is where the skill development comes. Now, you know, the point is, in one of the talks, you know, the Prime Minister gave a very interesting example. Someone came to his Guruji. He was a Guruji, you know, whom he often refers to. He said, sir, I don't have a job. And he said, what have you studied? He said, I got MBA in political science. Then the Guruji asked him, he said, can you fix the fan? He was like, and then he went on asking him, can you at least cook something? He said, no. Then he said, tell me what you can do. And then he said, I got the MBA in political science. So this is the tragedy of India. Our education system is completely diverse from reality. So that fellow, if you had not gone to college, at least you would have done something at his level. So now going to college, he has lost that and lost this. So, therefore, machines are going to take over whether you like it or not, unless we improve. Again, coming to our level, design engineers. Do you know how many design engineers we need?
Sorry.
The statistic says we need 400,000 per year, we produce 40,000. How many things have to be designed? How many things have to be simplified? We know. Every day you look at a fraudulent product and something made here, you know the difference. So that means some knowledge-based proper design. So designers, we are not able to do. So then you know all these things will be taken over by the robot. So this is the problem.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Dr. S. Barasivananda Prabhu to present a memento to Mr. Shankaran Srinivasan as a token of our gratitude.